Ah, a bucket. Whee! Here we are, the rooftops. Scritchy scratch. There's Zerk's ahead. I see him. Terrible little buggers. So, we haven't got that thing Doc was talking about with the spectral light. So, around we go. Whee! Where are we leading you, little Zerk friends? Not that you are my friends. Psych. Up here, follow the light. Get wrecked. Now, got a wall there we could jump across perhaps. Can we jump up there? Nope. Wall it is then. Zerk's down there. So press B to meow to attract the Zerks. So we attract them around one way and then we get around the other maybe to get through. Well dear. That doesn't bode well at all. Come here, Zerks. Idiots. Nice. That little box. Lovely. And so, what do you see here, B12? Strict energy caps, but now there's neon everywhere because of the darkness, yeah. Oh dear. Right, so people were being thoroughly oppressed down here then. They weren't even allowed lights. But then, collective action. Everyone started putting up lights and there was nothing the oppressors could do. Well done, everyone. Now, where's the way forward? It's not over that fence by the look. It's that beam, is it? Yeah, it is. Whoa! That was risky. And we can't seem to get up there. Can we get up there? No. Ah, we jump back onto it. I see. That's using your little cat brain. No, in the barrel, friend. There we go. Good stuff. And now, up and onto this, which allows us onto this. Sweet. So I'm not sure how the Zerks fit in with the oppressors and all that. I'm not sure how the oppressors fit in general. The Zerks, yeah, maybe it was just they were created as like a waste disposal thing and then it all just went horribly wrong. Come on in, Zerk friends. You lot will just stay in there. I'm just going to jump across to this side now, if you don't mind. Is that another Zerk up there? Just hanging out on the wall? It's not ideal if it is. Yeah, I guess that one didn't get the message. Ah, well. the Zergs create all this growth all over the buildings, or were they here to eat it all? Because if they were, they're not doing an amazing job of it. Now, what does this do for us? A plank and a vent. So I guess we're going into this awful looking room. Music is getting a bit tense. Right. Human personnel only. Lots of Zergs. Where are we going? What's our goal here? There's some light over there, and it's usually a case of follow the light. Can you reach me up here? You can. Terrible shit. Get off me. And we're dead. I didn't think they could jump up onto those pipes. They've not shown themselves to be the most athletic of aliens, these Zergs. But it shows what I know. They are actually pretty clever at jumping. So. What if we sprint? Whee! Wait, get off me. Get off me. There we go. Whoa, one of them nearly jumped up there. That's a bugger. Now, here comes some more. Yeah, you lot come round here. Yeah, you lot stay there while I run over here. Good. Have a box. Now, where's the next batch? Because there are probably more Zergs around. There's a bunch over there. So we can jump up here. There's a barrel in there that we'll need to move. But there's also Zergs, so let's open this door, lure them all out. Here they come. So whilst they're out there, we will jump up here, jump back down, and hack this door from this side. Nice. Alright. Is that actually going to help us? We've got them all around there at least. But no, I think we need to just keep this door open now at this stage. And then that allows us onto the beam. Good. Excellent. Another batch of Zerk outwitted. And these ones are just trying to jump at me and failing miserably. Good. Right, so what do you do? Leave a friend? Should we just be pulling levers without knowing what they do? Of course we should, but we can't. Consequences are for humans. No. guess we're just gonna have to keep them away while the lift comes down. Dodge and weave. I said dodge and weave. Ah, too many of them. Now, was there a smarter way to do that? I don't know. There's definitely nowhere else to hang out. So, yeah, I guess this is our only option, is to just serpentine it. Oi! I totally pressed A there to jump. Round we go. Ah, jeez, too many of them. Too many of them, surely. Oh, come on! What are you yelling about, Trace? Trace has caught Blue Mouse, and she wants to tell the world about it. I mean, she catches Blue Mouse all the bloody time. But she's still very proud of herself every time she does it. Sweet little bean that she is. Now, jumping seems to work well. Seems to slow them down. Oh, jeez. But then, as soon as they get you, you just seem to be dead. This is considerably less fun than the casual adventure puzzling that we were doing up until this point in time. Basically, because one of them gets you, they all just latch on and you're fucked. You can't jump anymore once one of them's on you. And then, yep, there we go, they're on a smoke. Oh, turn on a flashlight. I forgot we had a flashlight. And now we're dead. Right, jumping seems to just be complicating matters. So maybe we shouldn't jump, maybe we should just dodge and weave. Although, having said that, immediately goes back to jumping. There it is. Come on, lift. And then it doesn't even open. What? Why doesn't it open? Do I have to jump on top of it? Do I have to jump onto it from the side? I guess this episode is just going to be me failing to do this multiple times. So be it. Alright, let's go around that side. And sneak back around here. And then they all, fresh ones, just drop off and land on us. And then we're back. Right. There we go. We did have to just jump into it from the top there. Well, that wasn't fun. Glad none of them are falling into the open top of this lift when they clearly could easily do that. Now, up we go. And further about our business. Ah, good. So that was like the boss battle before we put the transceiver in. So is that Midtown we can see in the distance? Where the oppressors live, perhaps? Either way, I'm glad we've got a bucket to deliver us back to safety. It is beautiful up here. See, it was meant to be a shelter. Built this protects the cells from the outside. Hmm. So humans have destroyed the outside. Sounds believable. But now it's safe again. No humans out there, but it's safe. And B12 wants to open the city, so let's go see Momo, shall we? Yeah. This is a nice reward for... Oh, it's fading out. I was going to say it's a nice reward for completing that shitty fight, is seeing the city below us like that. But no, fade out and we're just here in Momo's house. The slums part two. Best lay claim to this carpet once again. Over some books, perhaps. Wait a minute. Has Momo gone for a stroll? Little outsider. That's us. He's gone to the bar. The code to open the window is that. Lovely. And of course, it's case sense. So, is that them? Momo, Clementine, Balthazar and Doc. Doc will be the one on the left, obviously. I guess Balthazar and Clementine are the two in the middle, although it could go either way as to which is which. Cool. Nothing else to do in the flat, I don't think. There we go. It's got the window open. Momo's at the bar. There's nothing else near that we need to do, I don't think. So I guess we're back down to ground level. Now, what have we got? Did we look at that before? Morusk. He wants the sheep music and he lives near the elevator. Good. Ah, this is Grandma. Hello, Grandma. Oh, you want to make me a poncho? That sounds fun. Lovely, we've got ourselves a poncho. Can we wear it? How does one wear it exactly? Thanks, Grandma. You're the best. Can we show you the poncho? We can. How do we equip the poncho? I wish to use it. Maybe we can't use it yet. Either way, who are you, friend? Do we know you? I'm not sure if we do. Do we know you two? Well, we don't seem to be able to talk to any of you, so let's have a look. We chat to you now? Oops. Sorry. That was an accident, my friend. Yeah, that was also an accident. Yeah. Still accidental. Does this count as knocking? It does. Hello. Can we meet you? Maybe. Are you Elliot? Oh, you're Nesta. Okay. Thanks, friend. Now, do you have any sheet music for me? Or any energy drinks? These are the important questions that must be answered. And there's an answer. Sheet music. Let's go see Elliot, shall we? It's a cool looking pad. Let's see if we can't get this window open. Nice. That might save us some time later. Hello, friend. Can you help us? I don't know. We don't appear to have any items for you. Oh, he likes the poncho. Thanks, friend. We'll be around if we need anything fixing. I guess we've got nothing that needs doing right now, but... yeah, we gave our new friend a poncho. Good stuff. I was hoping we could wear it ourselves, but I guess not. Bonsai tree? Nice. What kind robots these are. Now, that was a sign that said bar. And there's Momo. That's us. Little furball. What's going down, my friend? Up. Yeah. Definitely working. Kinda. It's Balthazar. They're safe, they found a way up. Gotta go through the sewers. Zerks everywhere. That's no fun. Guess we're going through the sewers then. Yeah, they probably will shame us. They have done multiple times. Gotta say, Jacob. Oh, Seamus is the son of Doc. Doc was working on a weapon to fight the Zerk. So we need that weapon. We need Doc's secret lab. We need Seamus's apartment. It's all coming up. Cat. And here we are, I guess. Please let us in, Seamus. always has an idea. Good. I mean, the usual idea is just breaking and entering. Take Doc's notebook. Right, so there's our new mission. Sneak on in. Breaking and entering, as expected. And then chat with Seamus. Let's have a look around first, though. Oh. He's awake. Right, Doc's notebook. Take a look at this, Seamus. It's a secret room in the flat. We'll find it. Finding secrets is what we do best. Oh. What have we found? Time will tell. Okay, nothing behind there. Nothing behind that either. I feel like there's nothing behind any of these now, and we're just knocking them over because we're a cat. Oh, there we go. So we need a code. Oh, and there's clocks. So what do the clocks say? 2511, by the look of it. Nice, time did tell. No sheet music in here though, is there? That's a shame. But hey, secret lab. Could be worse. So the weapon's been working in theory, but maybe not in practice. We'll get it to work. Bacteria of human time react to intense light. So that's why he made a light weapon of sorts. Speaking of, we keep forgetting to put on our thing. The Defluxor, a light based handgun. Yeah, can we jump up there? We can. It's important that we knock that box over. More zerks in jars by the look. Zerks are officially no longer under control. They will now eat metal. Yeah, as previously established, not great if you are a robot. What we found? A broken tracker? We can do things with that. Elliot could fix it. So if we can reverse the polarity, then we can find Doc. Nice. Right, back to Elliot then. We've given him a poncho, so we might have got ahead of ourselves there, and he should just be able to fix this up for us real quick. Hi, friend. As it happens, we've got a tracker that needs fixing. And now, there we go. Fixed tracker. Back to friend Seamus, I guess. Hello, Seamus. Thank you. got a ping. Let's follow the tracker. There we go, Shamo. Are you just going to be cleaning this up for the rest of the game, Cosmo? Right, guess we're going straight on here. We go into the elevator. So he's definitely left the slums. Momo can open this door for us, can't he? Or maybe Seamus can just open it. Maybe it's the elevator that Momo was in charge of. Or maybe he wasn't really in charge and the Guardian was just... I don't know. But either way, we've got another horrible Zerk-infested place to explore, probably. You be careful, Seamus. You're not as agile as I am. Let's have a quick poke around before we follow him. Just in case. Don't see any treasures though. So what are you going to say for yourself? Zerk eggs. Yeah, that's what I just said. So we're taking a badge. Oh, I see. It's the outsiders, yeah. Good man. And through we go. Into where exactly? Into what's presumably a new chapter. Let's see. And a new chapter, Dead End. It's full of Zerk. And I think it can wait. Until next time. Oh god, no it can't, we've fallen down. Well, we're boned. War's gonna end here, but... Hop! Nope, we can't jump across that. Never mind. And there we go. Our ninth death. That seems a good a place to sign off as any. And we'll be back next time to see if we can't keep Kitty in one piece for a bit.